Here's three tips on hiring and recruiting amazing fitness employees. Now, leadership and management isn't a gift you're born with. It's not something that happens because your team sees you as a friend or because you praise them all of the time or shower them with gifts and bonuses. It's not the opposite of that either. It's a push and pull balance where you're pushing them to grow on their own and pulling the absolute best out of them. And that's why it's important to lead from the front, which means two things. You're not afraid to be on the front lines and even get into the grind with your team, but also hiring the right people in the first place is extremely crucial so that you can have an upwards direction. Now, the first side of that is to build a pipeline early. I want you to treat your amazing fitness employees, recruitments, in your pipeline as leads. That's really the key. You've got to work good employees like they're leads. So I want you to gather a large pool of candidates, and I treat them like leads, and I work them off of a spreadsheet. Everything I put down is their name. We've got their phone number. And then I've got the last point of contact in what the last conversation that I had with them was. And this is how I'm gonna be able to manage my prospective candidates. Building a pipeline early is gonna allow you to have more candidates to choose from, and that way when you are ready to hire or somebody quits, somebody leaves, you're no longer in a position where you need to hire out of desperation. Point number two here is, where do you find these candidates? Now, we've got the usual Indeed, LinkedIn, but often some of the best people I've hired weren't looking for a job. And in that, sometimes we've got to recruit. We've got to go out to some of our competitors. We've got to go out to other fitness studios and find strong quality candidates. One of my most favorite things to do was to call a fitness studio in the area and ask the front desk, who's your favorite fitness instructor? Who's your favorite coach? I want to come take that person's class. The other people that know your employees or know who the best candidates are for your position are is your current members and your current employees. Your employees should know what it takes to be an employee at your studio. So you can always have an employee bonus if they bring you candidates that last with you 90 days, 120 days. Now, your members can often be really good potential employees, but they also know people that might be looking for positions and jobs in the industry. One of the other out-of-the-box ideas that you can do when looking to hire employees is to post a hiring video. Posting a hiring video is gonna give candidates a strong sense of what it's like to work in your studio. So now you can see, your potential candidates can see what working at your fitness studio is really like. So where do we go? We've got our usual spots. We've got Indeed, LinkedIn, right? Our regular job posting. You can often find candidates that are looking for jobs. We can also go out and recruit. We can also use our members and our current employees, and we can do a hiring video. The other side of this that you can also do is educational centers. There must be schools nearby you that have kinesiology programs, exercise and sports science programs. These educational centers can be a really great way to find young candidates that you can really mold into your fitness studio. Now, the final one, one of the most important ones, is the process. What is the process? The best way to hire a fitness employee. Now, if we're doing this right, maybe we've got 100 plus candidates, right? You can very quickly work that down off of resumes, and I want you to be picky. That's the awesome part of this. This allows you to get this, which allows you to be picky. Then I can slim that down to about 20 off of here. Resumes I like, people I want to talk to. So as far as the process goes, I want to screen the employee. We can screen the resume, we can screen some of the background, but then I'm also going to call them on the phone. Now, when that person answers the phone, I want to hear enthusiasm. I want to hear excitement, because so much of what we do is about enthusiasm and excitement. So if they're not answering the phone, hello, who is this? Right? Where's the enthusiasm there? Okay, so I'm gonna screen through a phone call. I wanna hear them. the next side of that, I'm going to invite them in to my fitness studio and I want them to take a workout. We want people to work for us that love our product. And how can they love our product if they have not taken our workout? Some of the best hires I've found were people that were products of the product. What does that mean? That person was either a member or that person has a transformative journey at your fitness studio. How awesome is it that I can talk to prospective members and say, I've been where you're at. I felt what you felt. I've had to lose weight. I've had to go through this. This studio helped me. What a way to sell a membership, right? So we've got to invite them in and see them taking the workout. Particularly with fitness coaches, I want to make sure that they understand form. I want to make sure that they look the part and look the role. You're probably wondering, well, where do I come in on this? And really, you don't come in until stage number three, which is the interview. I want them to go through in the invitation to work out. I want them to go through the entire workout process. Meaning if they arrive 15 minutes, 30 minutes early, because your studio requires that, I want them to come and experience exactly what it's like to be a first timer to walk into my studio. I'm not gonna be there when they arrive. I don't wanna be there. I'm gonna have them go through the entire process. The coach or the fitness instructor is going to onboard them into the workout. I will let the coach or instructor know before that I have a potential candidate coming into the studio because I want that fitness instructor to give them feedback during the workout. There are two people that I ask before I even get to the interview. Number one was the front desk or sales associate. Tell me, what type of attitude did that person have when they walked in? The next, I wanna talk to the coach. I wanna talk to the fitness instructor. And I wanna see what that person was like during class. Were they a know-it-all? Were they willing to receive feedback? Did they take feedback well? That's another big red flag if they don't take feedback very well. Now, sometimes, off of this 100, I've now lost a lot of people just on this invite to workout process. I won't even follow up with an interview. I'll say, hey, I just don't appreciate the way you spoke to somebody at the front desk, or hey, I need you to be able to take feedback. This isn't kind of the best sign, okay? Let's continue on with the interview, right? The biggest thing, I get asked this a lot, is how do you interview? What are you looking for? What do you say? And I'm not a big fan of a ton of different questions. My biggest factor is, would I like to go for coffee with this person? So, do you want to have dinner and lunch with that person regularly? Would you want to have that relationship? Because so much about this is, we're a small, compact group, 10, 12 people, right? So we really need them to be a part of this. Next, we might have an audition side of this. The audition is where that I'm able to screen and make sure. For my fitness coaches, I want to hear them on the microphone. I want to hear them coach a period of, or explain an exercise. I want to make sure their voice isn't too shrill. It's the right pitch. It sounds like a fitness coach. Otherwise, I've got to do development already. For some of our sales positions, I might want to audition and see some role play right there. I might want to hear how they might ask for a referral right there. The big thing in the audition process is they might not have the right scripts. They might not have the right processes. You should. And you do. But I need them to be willing and able. If they're willing and able, I can teach them anything. Now, as part of this interview as well, or audition, I wanna hear why they're interested in my company. This is why I invite them in to take a workout. I want them to be passionate about my fitness studio. The final thing, if you're doing this right, you don't have to hire immediately. And that is really critical in a fitness studio, is if you're not ready to select them, you can keep them continuing to take workouts. You might need to train them a little bit along the way, but you might not be ready to hire them right away. But the cool thing about that is that they continue to take workouts. They continue to be hungry. They continue to learn more about your culture so that when you are ready to hire them, they've taken 10 plus workouts. They've wanted to come in. They're free, come in, keep taking them. Become a product of the product, become really passionate about it. And that is how you're gonna be able to hire rather out of desperation. If you wanna learn more about this, check out the cheat sheet in the description below. And if you found this video helpful, please give it a like and subscribe for more videos just like this one.